A lot of the times people knew him for the ZSS, but he's right. really cleaning up the Falco. He uses Falco primarily in teams with Beast, his static partner. But we'll start on PS2. Falco Wolf, your usual spacey matchup.
And I actually love the way Juice decided to start that match immediately with the Reflector, because like 9 out of 10 Wolves are going to shoot
right.
a Blaster at the start of the match. Looks like the one out of that 10% being Arlor here did not give him that bait.
And Arlor starting out kind of with the lead. He, you know, a lot of Wolves do know their spacing pretty well. But Juice trying to find his footing back in, gets the fair for starting it off.
Go, trying to box his way in here. I like that down tilt from Arlor. He's actually been throwing out a lot of safe moves, hasn't really thrown out a hard commit at all. And that's kind of the nature of Wolf in a nutshell. You really do have the option of paying character like that, and it's paying off for Arlor here very well. Juice actually looking a little frazzled at the beginning here.
Right. But those combos that Juice gets, you know, the throws into the fairs, they hurt.
Oh, there we go. That falling neutral air into the up tilt going to be a bread and butter. You see some Juice as well, and he has him off stage.
Ooh. Waits a little bit long on the down smash.
He's going to dash forward up tilt a lot, trying to catch his opponent moving forward or jumping out of shield. And look at this ledge trapping, fading back with the down air, and then just doing another move to catch whatever other option Arlor's going for.
Looking pretty close for game one between these two. The edge guard. The edge guarding here is like very interesting. I feel like Juice is just kind of like waiting, and he got the hit now, but earlier it was kind of like he got the down air, but it didn't quite kill. But Juice now firing back with a pretty Uh-oh. Nice combo of his own.
And that's the thing in this game, Falco does kind of have his own pillars still. He can still send you up, bring you back down, especially on stage like Battlefield or Triplats. He really has some fortresses there, but a beautiful
F smash punish by Arlor. And I really liked the air dodge back to stage to avoid the laser. I mean, it wasn't all for nothing, but still kind of nice.
All right. So trying to keep him in the air here, keep the juggle going. I know a lot of anti-air options coming out from Falco, that up tilt, of course, and as well as that insanely quick up air to keep the punish juggled
nice.
And right into the back air. That confirm is so good.
And Juice firing up here. We'll see what he can do. But Arlor, kind of a little bit of a mountain to climb. A nice parry.
Ooh, that up tilt too. I'm actually pretty impressed with Arlor right now. Even though he's behind by a bit, he's definitely showing some expertise with Wolf.
Mm-hmm, for sure. Ooh. Up smash, not going to kill quite yet.
Right, no punish right there as well. Jumps over him with the back air, and wow, that actually KO'd. Wondering if that was a DI thing, or was that perfect percent? Looked like it could have been a little bit better from Juice there, but Arlor bringing it back, and this is kind of the percent that's easy for Wolf to get. You get a landing forward here, or a throw right here, or a down throw, or something like that. You're looking good.
Ooh,
there we go.
The Nair into the grab was a really smart idea, and now this is basically even between these two.
Exactly what I was talking about. Needs to get back on the stage, though. Needs to regain the footing. The ledge trapping from Juice has made it so hard. You see the way he always
Ooh,
fades
that grab,
back.
Goes. Juice really loves that back air, but he doesn't grab ledge and he eats a forward smash for it, and that's going to be game one. But let me tell you, that's pretty close.
It was, and that's the thing that I feel like the amount of Wolves I've seen lose in a last stock scenario due to using Wolf Flash instead of a Fire Wolf. It's so many. Like right there,
Fire
just,
Wolf.
I know, right? It's stupid,
is
right?
It
Where's the
is
fire?
Is it called Fire Wolf?
It is. It's dumb. That's the actual canonical name for it. Go up,
and
beef
we
it
are
up
going
Nintendo.
Smashville. The bands were Kalos and Yoshi's. I can't believe it's called Fire Wolf.
Yeah.
I don't see the fire.
Nobody anyway. Does. That's the thing that was hidden. It's like that low key beat that nobody knows about.
Here we go. Game two to Smashville. I kind of like this stage for both of the species. I mean, they both kill with their aerials kind of early. So, Juice starting out a little aggressively.
Man, for Juice here, I mean, he gets so much off of that platform in the middle, but I feel like he's been controlling center so well. Like, look at this. This is exactly what I'm scared for. I don't know if I really like this pick for Arlor here just because of the dominance Juice has been able to show just with his stage control, and this stage really kind of amplifies that tenfold.
Right.
But we'll see what he got. Close so far. Tech chase. Ooh, tries to read the tech in there. Won't find.
You know what I really like? I like Arlor is really kind of like working around Juice when it comes to like how he's getting back on stage. You know, he's realizing, all right, Juice is back a little bit. I'm gonna double jump onto the stage and there because that's safe. But that almost killed. Smashville for you, small. Goes for the grab, but he's gonna eat a back air.
Yeah, it looks like he missed a dash input there probably and just had him grab in place. And that led to that disastrous back air that confirmed the KO for Juice there. And oh no! Oh, he tried to go for the double dip, man. Not today.
Juice keeping his space here, waiting for his right time to approach and get these combos in. He really loves starting initiating with that up tilt. I mean, the up tilt is super, super good. You can combo it into so many moves, and oh my god, Juice!
I think he tried to spike him with the Phantasm there. I think he was expecting him to go for the Whiff Flash a little bit high and then spike him with that Phantasm because he didn't feel confident in spacing the down air, but didn't find it.
Arlor playing aggressively with the edge guard, which I really, really like. I mean, you're a spacer, you can do that. And Juice, like I said, aggressive.
Okay.
Up tilt.
Still
up air. Doesn't quite get it. Almost, though.
Oh, no. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Arlor shook his head. He's like,
yeah, it's like
I don't
a train.
Know if I like that one.
Got derailed a little bit there. Unexpected service delay from the Metro. But going back into it, can still bring it back. But now it's going to be so much harder. Juice putting on so much damage. Yikes.
Ooh, goes for that down air. Juice wants the
style.
Oh,
my God. Resetting these tech chases over and over, reminding
but
me of like the hip checks.
Firing back with two fares. He needs to keep his space again. That's what was working for him. But
later.
Juice just playing two close quarters, and you know, Juice is just gonna win these close quarter fighting.
The scuffles, the kerfuffles, the scraps. Scuffles. You know, whatever you want to call it, man. Whenever they got kind of into it, really that infighting, Juice 9 out of 10 times came out on top, and that's really what really led to his winning of that set, but also the way Juice was able to hold center stage. I felt like for the majority of both of those games, he really held it down there. But you know what? As I said, speaking of holding it down, while we do have a little bit of a moment here, let me go ahead and shoot